Most people go through life never discovering what their talents are. Most people never develop their talents. They have skills and abilities, but if you don't nurture them, if you don't develop them, they will never serve you. Your gifts can take you many places if you develop your gifts. Most of us don't like to do those things that come easy to us. If you decide to drop your buckets where you are and develop your gifts, I grant you that your gifts will take you places that will literally amaze you. There's greatness in you, and you've got to learn how to tune out the critics outside and the critic inside. And since I'm going to do this, I'm going to harness my will, and I'm not going to let anything stop me. Some reasons that when life knocks you down, and it's going to, when people disappoint you, and that's going to happen, when they betray you, and that's going to happen, when they lie to you, and that's going to happen, when they say, oh, you can count on me, and they won't show up, and that's going to happen, when you want to throw in the towel and give up yourself, and that's going to happen, when life collapses on you and catch you on the blind side, what reason can you remember that you can call on, that you can reach on, that can make you get back up? Find that reason. So life had knocked me down. I said, life, I'm doing this because I want to make my mama proud of me. I'm doing this because I want my children to have a better life than what I have. I'm doing this because all my life I've been told I'd be a loser, that I wouldn't make it. I'm doing this so I can become massively successful. What are the reasons that you can think of that can keep you strong, that can keep you in the game, that will be your rod and staff to comfort you? If you know the why for living, you can endure almost anyhow.
Michael Jordan, he had the most points in the game. But if you pay close attention, the guy that was in second place might have averaged 30 points. But because Michael Jordan scored 32, he made millions more than everybody else because he was the top as it relates to scoring. He was known around the world. Why? Because he sacrificed enough to get those one or two shots. And I'm telling you, you're not where you want to be financially. You're not where you want to be in your personal life. You are not the person you want to be. And it's not going to take you 20 shots. For some of you, it's one more shot. And you have not given yourself enough credit to say, I just need to get up a half hour earlier and my whole life will change. I just need to work 1 hour longer. I need to stop hitting that snooze button. If you were to make that one change, that one sacrifice, you would stop dreaming and start living.
You can write everything down if you want to. Be brave enough to write every one of your goals down. But I'm going to tell you something. Life's going to hit you in your mouth, and you got to do me a huge favor. Your why has to be greater than that knockdown.
Sometimes in life, you have to hit back.
Many of you right now, life's got you up against the rope, and you got to do me a favor. Like, you can't give up. You can't give in. Listen to me. If it was easy, everybody would do it.
Recycle your pain. Get something from it. You're already in pain. Use it. Do something with it. Allow it to take you to the next level. Allow your pain to push you to greatness. It's not always going to be easy. They're not going to give it to you. They're not going to give you success. They're not going to put it on the platter. But if you're willing to work for it, if you're willing to put the sweat, the blood, the tears, if you're willing to earn it.
You got to tell life, I don't know who you've been dealing with, but you come up against the wrong one this time.
When you have a vision for your life, other people will not have that same vision, so they will pass on you. Will you fold? Will you give in? Or will you rise above it all and unleash your visions and ideas and gifts on the world? Well, through it all, you decide. I am not here to be another person that lived and died and didn't do anything significant. I am here to create a shift in this universe. Unapologetically, I am going to get rid of all things, people, and situations that have become a distraction away from my vision. I am here with a purpose. I will stop at nothing. You will be physically and unapologetically removed if you get in the way of my vision. You're either going to be on this train or you're going to be knocked out.
Mind is everything. If you don't believe you can do something, then you can't. It's like you have to save your own life. Nobody's going to be able to save it for you. So we have to do what we have to do, no matter what it is.
You gotta face that fear. It'll change your life. You'll be able to push right through the pain. And when you're about ready to pass out, your legs can't move and your lungs can't breathe and your eyes can't see, you'll know it's just the beginning.
When you want something as much as you want to breathe, you will overcome the pain. And you will achieve greatness.
Success, guys, is a very, very lonely road, man. And along that road, you're not going to see too many friends. You're going to see your shadow most often. See, the thing is, for many people, they've tried the same path you're on, and they failed. You don't burn out mentally because you always burn out physically. You got trust in the heart of hearts, inside what you're doing, what you believe in is a worthy cause, a winnable fight. If you allow it to sit, it will grow roots and start breaking you down, destroying the potential of the person you can be. The champions, guys, it's not their potential, it's not their genetics. It's their perseverance to always show up. What I'm saying is the character of who you are. It's not the title that makes you, it's not the success that makes you. The character defines the success, defines the fame, and it starts right there. It's how you look at something, if your name's attached to it, that you do it right, the best of your ability every single time. Championships aren't won in the theater of the arena. They're won in the thousands of hours in the training room, in the labs, in the 5 a.m. runs, and when it's raining, when everyone else is sleeping, that's when it's won. The heart of a champion is a light switch that's always on. It doesn't go on and off if someone's watching. It's constant. Fear is self-imposed, meaning it doesn't exist. You create it, you can destroy it too. I love fear. The reason why? Behind every fear is a person you want to be. You face your fears, you become the person you want to be. You run from your fears, you're not living. You're alive, but you're not taking any freedom. If you face your fears, guys, that fear is destroyed. It comes back in its confidence. What else am I capable of? What else am I holding my back from that I'm capable of more? What am I running from I don't need to? What else can I overcome? When you embark this journey, you must know that it's going to go down before it comes up. But when it comes up, it's going to go so much higher than you've ever been. It begins right now with no one looking at it. Between a winner and a loser, this is the winner gets back up and does it again. It does it again until it goes his way. Sacrificing today for tomorrow's betterment. Something in the near future, relative future, that gives value to today. We all fall down in life. The question is, who gets back up? You go after and you give it all you have. If you lose, at least you try, man. I failed. It's 10 times more of a man than someone said, what if? Because what if never went to the arena. You've hit the wall someplace. You've looked in the mirror too many times and haven't smiled. You want to change the situation. Move from where you are. And you do it right. The best of your ability every single time. That's the same person who has his hand raised on the podium one day. Because it's hard. It's an uphill battle. It's a path less taken. That's what creates the champion.
Did you know the why for living? You can endure almost any harm.
When you refuse to turn around because of obstacles, when it gets rough, when you say, whatever price I must pay, I will do that. Life is too short and unpredictable to live otherwise. When you no longer focus on the obstacles, when you no longer care what people think or what they might say, when you no longer find the need to seek their approval, You are entitled to this. You're supposed to have this. This is your calling. This is the reason that you are here. This is your time. Once you get rolling on the track, once you get started, people will stand back and say, ain't no stopping her now. She's on the move. Look at her go. Look at her. Look at her. You got momentum working in your behalf. It's done. Why? Because you go past the point of no return. It's done. It's done in you before it happens out here.
You walk into your belief system. Look at your belief system every single day and stick with it. Don't rush the process. Trust the process. Don't rush the process. Trust the process. Don't rush the process. Trust the process. It takes 21 years to be 21 years old. You can't do it in 18 years. Keep playing the game. Keep grinding. Keep working. You ain't gotta be smarter than them. You just gotta be quicker than them. You just gotta be faster than them. You just gotta get to the spot before they get to the spot. You ain't gotta be them. You ain't gotta be on their level. You don't have to be as smart. You don't have to become them. You can stay you, but you gotta get there before they get there if you're gonna stay you. You better run, and you better run fast, cause your boy E.G., I'm coming to get it. I'm coming to get it. I'm coming to get it.
It's necessary that I live my dream, that I do my work, that I'm working constantly to express who I am. And I know that it stops here, that it's on me, that I'm the one that's got to do this. This is my signature on the planet. I know it's not going to be easy, it's going to be hard, but it's worth it because it's my life purpose. And if you advance confidently in the direction of your dream and endeavor to live the life you have imagined, you will meet with a success unexpected in promenades. You will put something behind you. Now the universe is lining up on your side because of your courage, because of your faith, because of your determination, because of your guts, because of your imagination, because of your relentlessness. The universe stands aside to the man or woman who knows where they're going.
Your dreams, your goals, your aspirations, your ideas, your thoughts. Everything that you ever dreamed and imagined is trash without action. Tomorrow is where the lazy get up and put into action, but nobody in this room is lazy. One of the most expensive things that you will ever experience in your lifetime is a missed opportunity.
This is my time. This is my moment. Tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. Ain't no such thing as tomorrow. We only got today.
The greatest opportunity in the world is found in today. Tomorrow, too far away. What about right now? What about right now?
You have an opportunity right now that you'll never have. You better not lose this. This is an opportunity of a lifetime. Your grandma counting on you to do the right thing. Your mama counting on you. Your cousins, your brothers and sisters are counting on you to cash in on this opportunity.
Today is all that matters.
The majority of people allow their dreams to die. It's hard living your dream. It's hard taking the heat in the kitchen. Most people won't do that. Most people don't have that kind of boldness about them. That kind of gutsy attitude about life. It's hard, yes. Changing your life, breaking habits, rebuilding yourself. It's hard. Starting all over again, that's hard. When you're in charge of your attitude, you say, if it's hard, then do it hard. Come up, stand up front, and take life on, and take it into power. I won't allow this to stop me. I don't have the option of easy. I don't have the option to try and take the low road. So what if it's hard? Do it hard. It's worth it. It's worth it to me to pay this kind of price. Really doesn't matter what you're going through. How you deal with it, that's all that matters.
Want to hear that crying no more? I'm tired. I'm tired of that whining. I'm tired. You got to get tired of losing. You out of place. Don't belong there. You are royal priesthood. Get your butt up. You don't belong at the bottom
And it's time for you to get your butt from down there. It's time for you to stop being comfortable at the bottom. Get your butt up and get to where you're supposed to be. Get where you belong. Do what you're supposed to do. Live like you're supposed to live. You gotta get this beast mode. You gotta embody beast mode. Everything about you has to say, I ain't playing. If it's to have, I'm gonna get it. And I ain't leaving none of it behind. It's mine. Beast mode.
Success is doing what you say you're gonna do. There's either the pain of discipline or the pain of regret. You get a reward for discipline. What do you get for regret? Guilt. So either you're gonna go through the pain of discipline and look a certain way and have certain things, or the pain of regret.
There is no excuse for not living up to your fullest potential. No excuse.
You got to have heart.
Get some heart. I stopped being a victim. I stopped saying I've got to wait for good things to happen to me. And I said I'm gonna grind. I'm going to fight. I'm going to work. I'm going to press toward. I'm going to learn. I'm going to do everything in my power. Every single day, I'm going to do everything in my power to become a victor and not a victim. I value myself enough to give 120%. Well, don't do it. You need to tell you that you owe you something.
Everybody's excited, everybody is on fire, but at a certain point you hit something along the journey and it's gonna test that level of commitment. At a certain point you're gonna hit something, it's gonna test that level of faith. And my definition of commitment was always staying true to what I said I would do long after the mood that I've set it in has left. Like, am I gonna stay true to my beliefs and my core and my essence of who I am as an individual? In life, people don't burn out because of what they do, people burn out because life makes them forget why they do. But when the purpose is intact, when the mission is intact, when it's about something greater than themselves, the opposition, the adversity, and the challenges are part of the journey. When things happen to redirection, it makes it even sweeter. When the purpose is greater and about something greater than you. The only thing I ask of you, never allow life to make you forget why you started in the first place.
A lot of people don't act on their stuff, don't act on their ideas and dreams because they are not perfect, because they're not pros, because they don't know how to do it. They don't know coming out of the gate. They haven't learned, and they're not willing to stumble and fall again and again. They're not willing to do that. They're not willing to have people laugh at them because it's not worth it to them.
So you've got to find something in your heart, something in your life that will make it worth it for you.
But you know that through this kind of opposition, that's how you develop strength. People that are making the dramatic difference on the planet, if you ask them, what will make you face this kind of heat, this kind of fire, this kind of rejection, they've found their pulse, they've found their place, they've found something inside themselves that has given them the strength, they will step forward and say, it's worth it for me to do this. When you love it, that love will help you bridge a lot of challenges. It will help you handle many obstacles. That kind of love that you have within yourself. And it will drive you. It will keep you going. Folks will look at you in total amazement. Say, how could she do that? Where does the energy come from? That when you get going, when you get rolling, when you can start coming at it again and again and again, when you feel sometimes that there's just no way there, and that you wonder where you will get the strength from. You want to give up, you want to fall down, you want to turn around and run with everybody else. You're going to question yourself. You're going to say, is this really making much sense? That's all going to happen to me. My life is worth whatever I have to do to come back again.
Let me tell you something. If tomorrow wasn't promised, what would you give for today? Forget that there was any sunlight left. What would you spend today thinking about? We get one opportunity in life. One chance in life to do whatever you're gonna do. Whatever legacy you're gonna leave, leave your legacy. And it's found through effort. Wins and losses come a dime a dozen. But effort, nobody can judge effort. Because effort is between you and you. Every day is a new day. Every moment is a new moment. So now you got to go out and show them that I'm a different creature. Now, because I'm pissed off for greatness. Because if you ain't pissed off for greatness, that means you okay with being mediocre. And ain't no man in here okay with being just basic.
In spite of what you might be going through, you get up. Rather than saying, I'm having a bad day today, you say, oh, life is getting exciting today. I'm building some good character today. Come on, life, whatever you've got, deal your best hand. I can take it. So you just work on your stuff, work on your strategy. Go at it, get knocked down, don't worry about it. Come back again. I can do this, I can do this. Change it up, change it up. I need to call this person, help me. I'll talk to this person over here. I'm gonna do this, here's another way. I can begin to improve it, massage it here. As you keep on working with it, working with it, working with it. Keep on doing it, doing it, doing it. When you love your stuff you're trying to find, how can I master it? You're excited about it. This is you. You are up working on ideas all the time. It's your piece. Why? Because it's worth it. It's worth the relentless effort and pursuit of your dream.
You call it a hobby, I call it a way of life. No way that you can stop me. You know that I've been training, right? The more you try to block me, the more that I control the fight. And now you on the ropes, now you on the ropes. What you gonna do? Quitting's not an option. That voice in your head that keeps telling you you got this, lied to you, and now everybody's watching. You should've worked a little harder, cause man, your punches are garbage. I dream big, ain't that the point of it? Let's keep it real, huh? Ain't that the point of it? They used to tell me I was nothing, nothing. Now they tell me that I'm something. What's it gonna take for you to understand the concept? I ain't really got no time for all the nonsense. See to you, this is a joke, a little project. I guess you'll never understand this kind of mindset. Started as a dream, grew into reality. Made a lot of sacrifices, that's how it has to be. I give it everything I got, ain't no way you passing me. I know we're in the same profession, but you're not a match for me. I'm on another level. I'm on another level. I said I'm on another level. On another level.
You must know who you are, but you must also know what you want. And when you know what you want, you never settle for less. Never settle for less than what you want.
So if you want $100, you're not taking 99, you're not taking 95, you're not taking 80, you are taking only 100. That's 120%, nothing less. Because when you settle for less, you're going to get less, you're going to achieve less. But you were born to be great, and you were born to accomplish great things. But you can only do that if you know who you are, and if you only settle for the best.
You will not begin to make your dreams become a reality until you become your own advocate, until you become your own savior.
Set your standard, and don't settle for anything less than your standard.
Evaluate where you are. Assess yourself and assess the situation. What brought you there? What role did you play? What has brought you to this point? What did you learn from it? Are you going through it or are you growing through it? Are you bigger and better because of it?
We call it life or death. You want to live a good, long, flourishing life? You got to push back. Can't just give in, you gotta push back.
It's not going to be easy when you want to change. It's not easy. If it were in fact easy, everybody would do it. But if you're serious, you'll go all out. So yes, I'm gonna turn this situation around. I'm not gonna sit back and moan and cry over what happened and what went wrong and who did what. I'm going to do something about this situation. It's hard, there's something that you're facing, some decision you got to make, something you're handling, and it's very difficult, very challenging. Here's what I'm suggesting. It's not going to be a cakewalk. You can't stroll to your goal. Once you take that into account, face the fact it's hard and go through with it. Do what you got to do. Do it. Because what you become in the process, if you hang in there, what you become as a person, the kind of spiritual growth, personal growth, the kind of commitment, the kind of things that you have within you now showing and revealing themselves that you would have not have known was there had you not gone through this. The harder the challenge, the greater the growth.
This day. Give it all. Spend yourself. If you could do more sprints, do more sprints. But when it's done, it's done. If you can't get up out of bed, that means that there's nothing in your life that is so important that you can't just get your ass up out of bed. You have nothing to live for, quite frankly. Because when you are moving towards something that's important to you, when you've got a big vision, you don't want to sit down. You can't rest. Every single waking moment of your day is dedicated to moving forward. And sleep, sleep is a waste of fucking time, right? And physiologically, of course, Elliot Hulse would say, well, you need sleep, supports your hormones. But what I'm saying is, that your vision, your mission, your goal, the bigger picture, how you're going to support other people, what you're going to build, create, and offer to the world means far more than a few extra hours of sleep. You know, it doesn't matter how you feel. It doesn't matter if you're tired. It doesn't matter if you're overwhelmed. You find out a fucking way to overcome that challenge of your feelings, and you make that shit happen. You understand?
We live in a world that we want to be as comfortable as we can. Our whole life is set up in the path of least resistance. We don't want to suffer. We don't want to feel discomfort.
We need to embrace the fact that it's hard, not avoid it. You got to fortify yourself and say, come on with it. It's hard, then handle it. I've got to step into it. Take a stand, anybody. It takes courage to live, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to be faced with a series of opposition, all kind of obstacles in your path. Yes, all kind of hurdles you're going to have to overcome. But as you do that, the harder the battle, the sweeter the victory. As you do that, as you go through that, when you come through, ladies and gentlemen, when you come through that valley, when you come through that fight, there'll be a look in your eyes that everybody will know this is a different person here.
Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become.
You gotta find something within. And when you find out what your why is,
you don't sleep day or night to get it. Because every second spent not doing so is time wasted.
People who are running toward their dreams, life has a special kind of meaning.
When you find your why, you find a way to make it happen.
When there's a will, there's a way. When you truly need something, you can find a way, and you stop at nothing to reach it.
What you will realize is that you have greatness within you. What you'll realize is that you're more powerful than you could ever begin to imagine.
If it's hard, why do people do it? People who climb mountains just for the sake of it. Nobody paying to do it, just do it. Somebody said, I'm going to run around the world. He said, why would somebody want to do that? I'm going to swim the Atlantic Channel. Why? It's got to be your passion. You got to love it, ladies and gentlemen. You got to love it. It's got to be what you are supposed to do. You do what it is you're supposed to. You're supposed to build something. You're supposed to create something. I don't know how to do it. Learn. Do whatever is required. Just go out there. It's possible you can get what you want. It's necessary. If you want it, you got to go into action. You got to be willing to experiment. You got to be willing to fail and to succeed. You got to be willing to form and develop new relationships. It's you. It's on you. You got to make that happen. Nobody's going to bring it to you on a silver platter and say, here's your dream manifested. No, it's hard. Yes, it's hard. It's difficult. Yes, right. And it's worth it.